Welcome back. You're watching Breakfast. 25 years on from its Britpop origins, one musician wants to start a conversation about mental health and gender equality and, of course, have some new music alongside it.
Former Supergrass singer Gaz Coombs has written about his own battles with a number of things, anxiety, feeling vulnerable in his new album. You're here now, sitting on the sofa, Gaz.
Morning.
I was grinning rather a lot when you first came back then because I said which my favourite track was on the new album and you said I had good taste, which I'm rather chuffed about.
You made the right choice. Yeah, you kind of chose like an album track. Which is kind of cool, you know, rather than the obvious single.
Charmer.
That's what he said, the man said.
You know,
should we see what Gaz is talking about? Here's another one of the tracks in the album, Deep Pockets. Let's go far. We'll spend more time in cars. Like the stars. Oh,
that's funny, isn't it, guys? People start writing about what you're writing about and their interpretations of what's going on in your songwriting. A lot of people are talking about this thing about you addressing issues around masculinity and how men are coping these days. Is that fair? Are they reading too much into what you're doing?
It's interesting. I mean, I didn't set out to, you know, write a record about mental health and masculinity. I think it was just a snapshot of my headspace over the last sort of 2 years, you know, and various experiences and ideas and thought processes. And so, you know, it just kind of creates this sort of chaos of ideas. And then the whole kind of thing is to pull it into some sort of coherent, you know, framework. And it's cool if, you know, people pick up on things. It's fine. It's great. I mean, I guess the things that they've picked up on are very important and worth discussing. And yeah, definitely.
And personal.
But, you know, I just do my thing. And then other people kind of pick up on stuff, and that's the way it works.
Well, you've spoken about issues that you deal with in your personal life and your family life as well. You've spoken about your daughter's autism, and that's coming through in music. How does that sit with your family?
Well, my daughter loves it. She thinks she's the centre of everything. You know, it's okay. Amazing. But you know, it's just, I guess I just write about what inspires. You know, and she inspires me. I think she's amazing in the way that she looks at life, and you know, I think that's worth celebrating. You know, the quirks and the oddities and the unusual traits of us humans, and I think that's what this album's about. Really, it's sort of about humanity and about just the way I kind of explore what's around me and what I notice in people and what I notice in what's happening in the world around us.
Have you always been this reflective with the music when you're writing with Supergrass?
Yeah, I think yeah, definitely. I think it's always been in there. I think if people were to go back through all of the records, I think they'd see these moments of I don't know, philosophical moments or just, you know, seeing things sort of under the surface, you know. Yeah.
Now, I'm not sure. Now, this Top of the Pops, and I'm not quite sure.
Do you
know what year that is? Are you good on these things, Gaz? Can you sort of identify from what you're wearing,
that's
whatever?
That's my brother, Rob. That's going to be, like, 98, 99.
And when you look back at that stuff and that time, I mean, happy memories, blurred memories, what kind of memories are they?
I have no recollection whatsoever. No, you know, it's great, you know? It just shaped my life and, you know, made me who I am and... you know, we had some brilliant times, and
but
I'm always about looking forward. You know, I can't sort of stand still. I wouldn't want to kind of, you know, rest on that sort of legacy. It's kind of about pushing forward and trying new things, you know, and evolving. It's sort of, you know, this is Gaz 2.0. Actually, no, 2.0.1. I'd had a little update this morning.
Well,
bug fix.
Oh, and now I don't want to be too personal, but one thing that hasn't changed. You're talking about evolving. You've still got the sideburns.
Yes.
Now they are a constant. They're something. They're a feature, and they remain so.
Yeah, it's just part of my face.
And this look here, I'm drawn to this picture. It's got a hint of kind of John Travolta about it, the white suit thing going on there. What's the look you're going for there?
I just like clothes, man. I picked some stuff up, and then I was over in LA doing that shoot for the album cover, and the good friend of mine, photographer Steve Keros, and he's like, Gaz, I like this suit. So, it's just clothes, you know?
Do your children ever comment on your music and your suits? I mean, you said your daughter loves the fact that you're writing about her, but your image and stuff. Because there's that awkward age, isn't there, when kids find their parents embarrassing. However cool you are, you will at one point be dancing dad. Do you know
what
I mean?
Well, yeah, my 9-year-olds often sort of, ask me why I've turned up to school in sunglasses. And I've just said, well, because it's sunny. But, she's sort of, I think she kind of thinks that, this kind of rock and roll thing. But, no, they're getting used to it, it's all that they've known since they were born. So, they're pretty kind of on the level with it. But I make them little mix CDs with sort of trying to push other music that I like on them, because they're kind of, they're in the grips of the pop world, and, it's quite a powerful machine. The pop world, and they so I'm kind of trying to push other things on them, and that's quite cool. Yeah, and then I slip in my tracks as well.
Right.
Yeah, but it's good. They really like the new album, actually. They're kind of big fans.
Yeah, I enjoyed your new album.
Oh, thanks.
It distracted me.
Hey, do you know, it's out today.
Is it? Yeah. Is that why you're on?
It's like Christmas morning.
And the album.
Is that why I'm on? No, it's not that cynical. I was just passing by the building. Thought I'd pop in.
Do it anytime you like.
Thanks, guys.
The album's name, if you're curious, out today. World's Strongest Man.
That's it from us today. We'll be back tomorrow from 6. Have a lovely day.